Good morning all. So last class we started with the moment of inertia, right? Module 4 part B. Can anyone define what is moment of inertia? What is moment of inertia? It is the second, what? Second moment of
area.
Correct. It is the second moment of area. Matlab A into D is nothing but moment of a area. Area into the perpendicular distance. If I multiply it again by the perpendicular distance, this becomes AD square, that is second moment of area. Twice we are multiplying. So based on this, the definition for moment of inertia is, it is the second moment of area. It is used where? It is used in the stress analysis of beams and all, also where we deal with the pressure measurements or pressure analysis in submarines, correct? So that is the application and the definition of moment of inertia. Based on this, we had generalized equation we had obtained. So what was that? Ixx is what? Integration of, now the diagram is like this. This is the body, this is your x-axis, this is your y-axis. X axis ko y distance aega, y axis ko x distance aega, correct? So what is Ixx? Area into what distance?
Y square.
Somebody was y square, yeah. Y square into dA, right? If I'm taking an elemental area, if I know the total area, it will be written as y square into A, right? So this is Ixx. Iyy, on the similar lines, we can write it as x square into A or x square, integration of x square into dA if it is an elemental area, right? So these are your Ixx and Iyy, that is moment of inertia about xx axis and about yy axis. After this, there is something called as polar MI, polar moment of inertia. Can anyone tell me it is denoted by what? Polar MI denoted by I?
ZZ.
Correct. IZZ. And any equation for this? Or in general terms, it is integration of R square into dA. Right? R being the radius, if I'm talking of polar moment of inertia. Correct? So these were the generalized equation. After this, we studied something called as radius of gyration. Right? So can anyone define what is radius of gyration? Don't define, give me the formula for that. Radius of gyration, what is the equation?
Root of Ixx by A.
Under root Ixx by A, or it could be under root Iyy by A, right? Or it could be under root Izz by A. In general, we will write it as I by A. Correct? Radius of gyration. And what is radius of gyration in that when we were dealing? We denoted it by Kxx. When we further study higher engineering, it is denoted by R. Rxx or Ryy, or it is called as R minimum, is going to be I minimum by A. A stands for the overall area, I stands for moment of inertia, whichever is the least. So this is your radius of gyration. Then after radius of gyration, we studied something called as, there were two theorems, parallel axis theorem and perpendicular axis theorem. So perpendicular axis theorem. What is this? If you can give me the equation also is fine. If not the statement, give me the equation. Absolutely. Izz is equal to Ixx plus Iyy. Based on this, if we write the statement for or the definition, it is to find the moment of inertia about the third or polar moment of inertia, it is got by the sum of the moment of inertia of the other two mutually perpendicular planes. All three planes are going to be mutually perpendicular to each other, right? X, Y, Z. We are aware of this from mathematics. So the polar moment of inertia is got by the sum of the other two moment of inertias. This is the perpendicular axis theorem. Second, we studied for this when we do the, there is a proof, right? So this is the area, this is the distance r. So this distance is x, this distance is y. If this is x, this is going to become x. So using the Pythagoras theorem, r square is x square plus y square, and then substitute for in integration of izz is what? Integration of r square into dA, substitute for r square, x square plus y square, and then you will get ixx dA and iyy, so not ixx, sorry, it is x square dA and y square dA, which means it is the sum of x and y, correct? So we have seen this, and after this we studied parallel axis theorem, second one. So parallel axis theorem. What is parallel axis theorem? Can anyone give me equation? I A B say is given by
IG plus AD square.
IG plus AD square. Absolutely right. Meaning, if I have a rigid body and there is for the rigid body, it will have its centroidal axis. See, this is that centroidal axis xx because this is the center. And if I consider elemental area dA, and then I want to find the moment of inertia about this AB. Apart from its centroidal axis, I want this area's moment of inertia about AB. So first, IG stands for moment of inertia about its centroidal axis parallel to this AB. So here, this is IG plus AD square. D forms the distance between these two. The distance between the centroid and where you want to find the moment of inertia. So IAB is given by IG plus AD square. This is the D. Okay. This is parallel axis theorem. Very important. It will be asked state and proof parallel axis theorem. You should know the proof. It is also simple, not very difficult, right? Then after this, we took up a first derivation for rectangular section, correct? So we considered a rectangle like this, and centroid pi, this is xx, this is yy. We called its breadth to be b right here, and depth is d, correct? Then from the centroid, this becomes d by 2 and this becomes d by 2. Here, this is going to be b by 2 and this is going to be b by 2. This is the CG point, right? Now from this, here, when I want to find ixx, to xx, I will take parallel a elemental strip of width dy at a distance y, correct? From this, we will start doing the derivation, that is, what is dixx, matlab, the moment of inertia of this elemental strip about xx it is. So it is going to be what? Y square into dA, the second moment of area. So dA into y square, right? What is dA? dA is this area of elemental strip. So it is given by b into dy, correct? Therefore, dixx becomes now y square into dA is b into dy. Right now, if I want only ixx, I will put the integration sign towards this. B we can take it out, and here it is y square into dy. So when we simplified this, for this, what are the limits? This elemental strip can be ranging from here to here, but our centroidal axis is here. So we tell it, take limits as minus d by 2 to plus d by 2. So minus d by 2 to plus d by 2 are the limits. So when I apply the limits, we got a formula for ixx. Can anyone tell me what is the formula for ixx?
B d cube divided by 12.
B d cube by 12. Absolutely right. See, when I want x axis, parallel to x, what is there? B is there. So that is for only one time. Perpendicular to x is d. That is cube by 12. On the same lines, if I want to write iyy. Okay, I want to write iyy. Matlab like this. So iyy may parallel to this is d. So d becomes 1 once and perpendicular is b. B is cube. So I will write it as db cube by 12 iyy. Right? So we had stopped it at this junction. Am I right? Yes, no? We stopped it there, no, the other day. Or had we done even IAB? Somebody answer. We didn't do, no? We stopped it at that point. So this is our figure. This is dy at a distance y. Right? This is AB. Now, we have found for this particular figure, these all derivations are important, okay? They come. So for this particular figure, we found Ixx, which was BD cubed by 12, and we found Iyy, which is DB cubed by 12. DB cubed by 12, right? So these two are moment of inertia of a rectangle about centroidal axis. XX is what? X is passing through the centroid, no? CG of that figure. So whenever I have axis passing through the CG, it is called as centroidal axis. So IXX and IYY are the centroidal axis. And this BD cube by 12 and DB cube by 12 are MI about centroidal axis. Now, if I want to find the moment of inertia of this entire figure about its base, okay, this is the base of the rectangle, AB, okay? If I want to find it about the base, that is at this point, here I will apply the parallel axis theorem, okay? I will apply parallel axis theorem and get the moment of inertia about IAB. Clear? So, next part of the derivation is continuation, it is okay. The moment of inertia MI about the base, okay, about the base AB, that is this one. I want to find MI about this, about the base AB, can be found using parallel axis theorem. Right now, I know what is parallel axis theorem. It is IG plus AD square. Right now, when I before applying the tell me the distance between CG of the figure and AB is how much? CG of the figure is this, and AB is here. What is this? How much is this distance?
D by 2.
Correct. D by 2. The distance between the CG of the figure and AB. I took AB because I want to find MI about AB. If there was some other here, some other plane, then I had to find the distance between that and the other plane. Okay. So now here, this distance. So according to parallel axis theorem, from parallel axis theorem, what is the equation? IAB, that is about the base parallel, is going to be IG plus AD square. Correct? IG plus AD square. IG is what? IG is moment of inertia about the centroidal axis. Abhi meko bolo, what plane is parallel to AB? XX is parallel to AB or YY is parallel to AB? XX axis is parallel or YY axis? X, no? Only one Shifa has answered. XX. Parallel axis theorem name itself is, I have to look for the centroidal axis which is parallel to the required one. Now, AB is a required one. Parallel to AB is XX axis. So, this equation becomes what now? This is IG matlab IXX plus AD square. Okay? Now, I know IXX. What is IXX? BD cube by 12. So let us substitute. It is BD cube by 12 plus area. What is the area of this entire rectangle? What is the area of this entire rectangle?
B into D.
B into D. Correct. So I will write B into D is the area, and this D stands for the distance between the CG of the figure and the axis where you want to find the MI. So that we have already written, it is D by 2. So here this becomes D by 2 the whole square. Open the brackets and start solving. BD cube by 12 plus, this becomes what? This is D square by 4. So here it becomes B D square and D, BD cube by 4. Am I right? So 12 being your LCM, 1, 3. So this is 1 BD cube plus 3 B, sorry, BD cube. So 1 plus 3 makes it 4 BD cube by 12. If I cancel, so what am I getting? BD cube by 3. So IAB, that is moment of inertia about the base for a rectangle, is given by BD cube by 3. Formula this is, we make use when we are doing the numericals. Okay, so when I want to find the MI about the base of a rectangle, it is BD cube by 3. Along the X and Y axis, it is BD cube by 12 or DB cube by 12. About the base, using parallel axis theorem, we have got BD cube by 3. This ends the derivation. Okay, I have to find IXX, IYY and the about the base. Now to this, if I ask you to find the polar moment of inertia in this, say polar MI, find me the polar moment of inertia, that is IZZ. From perpendicular axis theorem, I know that IZZ is IXX plus IYY. So substitute, IXX is BD cubed by 12, IYY is DB cubed by 12. So I have to take 1 by 12 outside, or you can take B and D also common outside. So this will be D square plus here it is going to be D square. Okay, it may, don't do anything much changes. This much only you can keep. This is the polar moment of inertia formula. And in this, if I ask you to find the radius of gyration, if it is asked, simply substitute. Okay, so say XX, KXX is going to be IXX by area, under root, right? So under root, IXX is BD cubed by 12 and area is B into D. So B and D will be going here. So what is left? Under root D square by 2. Correct, no? D square by 2. Anything? Am I missing something? Okay, this was 12. 12 it is. This is D square by 12. So if I want to open the brackets for this, or under root, so D square will be D, and here I can write 2 root 3 because 2 2's are 4, 3's are 12. So 2 I can take it out and this makes it 3. So D root 3 is the KXX. Similarly, you can find KYY also, but note me. Just I showed you if they ask how to do. Clear? So this is about radius of gyration and this is about polar MI. Here I want to discuss one more thing. What is the unit of MI? Can anyone try? What would be the unit of MI? You want to try? What is the unit of moment of inertia? Quickly, see, if ever you get this question like this, unit, so of moment of inertia. So write the equation for moment of inertia first. Say, take any equation. Say, I know IXX now for the rectangle is BD cubed by 12. Correct? So what I will do, I will substitute these parameters in their units. B and D are what? They are the dimensions. Either they can be in meters, they can be in centimeters, or they can be in millimeters, right? So usually we take it in millimeters. So B is in millimeter, B cube also is going to be millimeter divided by 12. So what is this? Kg, kahan se aaya Shifa? From where kg came, beta? There is no load only. लोड कहाँ है यहाँ पे केजी आने को? यस प्रशांत, राइट. सो एमएम इनटू एमएम रेस टू 3 मेक्स इट एमएम रेस टू 4. 12 इज अ कांस्टेंट, इट विल हैव नो मोमेंट्स. सो एमएम रेस टू 4 बाय 12 माने एमएम रेस टू 4 ओनली यू कैन कीप इट. ओके, सो मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शियाज यूनिट आई इज ऑलवेज गोइंग टू बी एमएम रेस टू 4. व्हेन यू डू न्यूमेरिकल्स इट इज इंपॉर्टेंट यू राइट एमएम रेस टू 4. क्लियर? On the same way basis, if I ask you the moment, units for K, k is what radius of variation. So the formula is what under root I by a. Okay. So under root I ka unit now we got to know mm raised to 4. Area is units what? What is unit of area? Mm raised to 2. Correct now. So mm square will go here and mm square is left. Under root of mm square, what is left? Mm. So kxx, its unit is going to be mm, right? So whenever you don't know any unit, you want to know any unit, then for in that particular formula, substitute the units of the other parameters, you will get the unit of that entity. Clear? So moment of inertia is going to be always in mm raised to 4. So this was about moment of inertia of a rectangle. Now we will be doing moment of inertia for a triangle. So the basic figures what we did CG, the same basic figures are there here also. So we will write or we will do the derivation for triangle. Okay. So find the moment of inertia for the given triangle. So the diagram goes like this. This is the triangle. And this is the base of the triangle, IAB. Okay, we know where is the CG of the triangle. Where is the CG of the triangle? Like this. At what distance? Where is the CG of the triangle? You did CG, unit. Consider a triangle of base B, base is B, and height of H. Choose a horizontal strip of length B dash. Okay, the length of this horizontal strip is going to be B dash. This is B, this is B dash. Choose the length of the horizontal strip as B dash and width of this strip to be D of Y. Okay, it is acting at a distance Y from the base. So this distance, this elemental strip is at a distance of y from the base. Okay, now from the, we did the same type of derivation when we did CG of a triangle, the same concept here. I want to know the value of b dash. To know the value of b dash, I have to use similar triangle rule. B dash by this distance is going to be equal to b divided by this distance. Okay, so what is this distance here? Can anyone tell me how much is this? This is h, this is y. How much is this? H minus y. Absolutely right. Okay. So here if I apply similar triangles from similar triangles, you will not write like this. You will write in words in the examination. It is going to be b dash divided by h minus y is going to be equal to b divided by h. Correct? From this, what is b dash going to be? B dash is going to be b into h minus y divided by h. Why I want b? Because always we deal with the area of the elemental strip. And for area of the elemental strip, it is b dash into dy. So I need the value of b dash in terms of the other parameters. That's why first we apply similar triangles, get the value of b dash. Okay. So once we have got this, in a rectangle what we did, we first found the moment of inertia of the body at its centroid first, correct? Not at the base. We found at the centroid and then we found at the base using the parallel axis theorem. Now what we will do in case of a triangle, getting the moment of inertia about the centroid is a bit tedious. So we will find the moment of inertia first along the base. What we will do? I will first find IAB, okay, moment of inertia about the base. Then I will do IXX if I want to find. I will apply IAB is IXX plus AD square, correct? So if I get this value of IAB, then I can find IXX as IAB minus AD square. So to make use of this and get the centroidal axis moment of inertia, first I will find IAB. So here we will be first obtaining the moment of inertia about the base. Okay. So write that down. The MI about the base AB is given by DIAB is going to be equal to what? It is the second moment of area. It is y square into dA. Y square into dA. So what is the value of dA? We know that dA is going to be b dash into dy. B dash into dy. What is b dash? It is b into h minus y divided by h into dy. Correct? So this is the value of dA. This goes here now. So what happens to IAB? IAB is now going to be equal to, right? Here y square into dA is b into h minus y divided by h into dy. If I want IAB, I will have to put this side. Sorry, this is DIAB. Okay, DIAB. If I want IAB, I will have to put integration sign to this entire thing. It becomes y square into b into h minus y divided by h into d of y. What are the limits, can you tell me, for this? Limits from here to here. That is 0 to h. This has to be integrated now. Clear? To integrate this, first what I will do, I will take this, I'll open the brackets. So integration 0 to h, y square bh minus y square or y cube b, y cube b, okay, divided by h into d of y. Okay, now if I here I take b and h common, what will be left out? So b by h I'll take common, and 0 to h I will be left up with y square into h minus y cube d of y. Right, now integrate it and use the limits. So IAB is equal to b by h is outside, y cube h by 3 minus y raised to 4, that was y cube, no, that becomes y raised to 4 by 4, 0 to h is the limits. I substitute for the limits, I will have b by h into h raised to 4 divided by 3, okay, minus h raised to 4, this is 3, what did I miss? Anything went wrong? 4, 4, no, okay, correct. Divided by 4, right? Now, I have to put 0 and h once. So when I take that b by h, this becomes 4 h raised to 4 minus 3 h raised to 4, keeping the LCM as 12 like this. So 4 minus 3 is 1. So what am I left up with? IAB is going to be 1, 12 is at the bottom only. So B and H is here only, and 12 is here. This becomes H, because 4 minus 3 is 1 times of H raised to 4. This H will go with this H, and I'll have BH cube by, it's visible, BH cube by 12. This is IAB. All of you have to try this. Without the trial, it will not come. So we'll get IAB, that is moment of inertia about the base, as BH cube by 12. BD cube by 12 was for rectangle. BH cube by 12 is for the triangle. BD cube by 12 was centroidal. BH cube by 12 is about the base of the triangle, not centroidal. Okay, don't confuse. This is about the base. Now from this base, I have to do reverse and get the value of IXX. So what we will do? Use a different page. So now I know that IAB is BH cube by 12, correct? So I want IXX. Therefore, I will use the parallel axis theorem, that is IAB is going to be equal to IXX plus AD square, correct? So here, I know the value of IAB, that is BH cube by 12, is going to be equal to IXX plus area of a triangle, half base into height. D is what? D is the distance of the CG, of the centroidal axis and where you are taking the moment of inertia, right? So what is this distance? Where is the centroid lie in terms of a triangle? What is this distance? CG of the triangle, I'm asking. What is this distance?
H2.
Yes, come again. 1/3, 2/3, remember? From the base, it is how much? CG of the triangle from the base is how much? 1/3 or 2/3? Quickly. This distance is 1/3 or this distance is 1/3? Which is 1/3 and which is 2/3? Okay, y'all are used to this triangle. This is the CG of the triangle. What is this distance? If this is the base B, what is this distance?
1/3.
1/3, no? Here, when we did derivation for centroid, we did the derivation for such a figure only. Why so much time? So this distance is 1/3 and this distance is 2/3, no? Same it is. Here it is a right angle triangle. This is something like your isosceles triangle. That's it. This distance is always going to be 1/3. 1/3 of what? Total height, h. So here, d is distance between the CG and where we are taking moment of inertia. That is going to be h by 3, the whole square. D square, no, h by 3 is the d, the whole square. So Ixx is what now? Ixx is going to be bh cube by 12 minus, this comes to the other sides. That is bh cube by 6. Solve this and tell me what is Ixx quickly. Solve it and tell me what is Ixx value.
Ma'am, bh cube by 18. No, ma'am. You have written bh cube by 6. It is bh cube by 18.
Yes, 3, 3 is a 6, 2 is a. Hey, no. 18, correct. I have written 18, 12. Correct. Three threes are 9, 2s are 18, correct. Get me the value of Ixx. Thanks, huh?
BH cube by 36.
Correct. BH cube by 36. Okay. That means when I have a triangle like this, okay, and we know the CG of the triangle is here, this XX, say, and this is going to be YY because this is the CG point and this is your AB. So along the base, IAB is BH cube by 12. First, we found this, right? And then from here, we applied the parallel axis theorem and got the value of Ixx, which is bh cubed by 36. These formulas, you should memorize them because while solving the numerical, without this, you cannot go ahead, right? So Iab and Ixx, this is for what? This is for a triangle. Clear? Next, we will do for a circle. So first 2-3 class are usually derivations. These all have to be done and they're important. One derivation from CG and one derivation from MI, 100% will arrive, right? We have got figures in when we were dealing with CG. We have standard figures, that is rectangle, triangle, sector, quarter circle, semicircle, correct? This is the CG, sector of a circle we have done, 2-alpha instead of angle. For MI, again it is a rectangle. It is a triangle. It is going to be a circle and a semicircle and a quarter circle. Clear? MI of all these figures. So total how many? This five, you have total 10 derivations. All are on the same lines only, especially when it enters this part. Sector, quarter circle, semicircle, or circle, semicircle, and quarter circle, when it enters this region, these only limits change. Like here we had minus alpha to plus alpha. This became 0 to 90. It is 0 to pi by 2. This became what? Minus pi to plus pi, 0 to 180, right? Here also the same thing. Everything will remain same. The limits will change, so the values will change. And out of here and here, one sure will come. One derivation from CG, one derivation for MI, 100% is going to arrive, right? So you have to practice and understand it rather than mugging up. Okay, we will take up first circle quickly. So find the moment of inertia of a circle. And when I'm doing for a circle, obviously I will not do for IAB. AB matlab base of a circle. Because circle is going to be like this. So I can't have a base. If I still want, I can draw a line over here at the base and we can do that, right? So first we will do for along the centroidal axis. So this is a circle. This is a centroidal XX axis. This is a centroidal YY axis. Now, unlike or like when we had done for CG of a circle or a sector of a circle, I need to consider elemental strip like this, wherein there are two parameters coming into picture. The strip will have angle also 0 to 360 and it will have radius also 0 to r as limits. Matlab double integration comes into picture for moment of inertia of a circle, semicircle and a quarter circle. Are you aware of double integrations? Have you done double integration? Simple only, but have you done double integration? Yes, no, you can type it in the chat box.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So yes, we will have to do double integration here because the radius also will have a limit, 0 to r, and the theta also will have a limit, 0 to 360. In this case, 0 to 90 in quarter circle, 0 to 180 in a semicircle. So both have to be taken. So when I have two parameters which are going to change, that indicates I will have double integration coming into picture. So consider an elemental strip like this. Okay, of this is going to be dr and radius is r, okay, at an angle theta, and it is making an inscribed angle of d theta, right? Now, as I had told you, it becomes like this, right? So CG of a triangle, we know, if I consider this as force, this is 1/3 of r, this is going to be 2/3 of r. And if I take the component cos and sine, 2/3 of r cos theta. We have used this in center of gravity. Okay. X component becomes 2/3 of r cos theta. And y component becomes 2/3 of r sine theta. We will be making use of this y component and x component. Okay. So first, consider a circle of radius equal to r. Right. Consider a circle of radius equal to r. And choose a differential element of angular wherein the theta will be changing and radial width also will be changing. So we will have d theta and dr as our two parameters with differential elements because of the differential elements, right? Then dA, area of this elemental strip I want. What is the area of this elemental strip? This is dr and I want the length here. Length of the arc is given by what? R into d theta, correct? Length of the arc, so R into d theta. So when I'm writing dA, it is going to be equal to dr. Now the your elemental strip is looking like this. So the, here it is R into d theta, and this is going to be your dr, correct? So dA is going to be what? It is d of R into d theta. Am I right? So dA becomes equal to r into dr into d theta, right? This is the area of the elemental strip. Now, the distance, is visible? Okay. The distance of this area, the distance of this area this area, or elemental area is a better term, okay, of this elemental area from CG, okay, from here I need to find that distance, is given by y equal to r sine theta, that is the component. This distance will be divided into two, r cos theta, r sine theta, right? So CG, if I'm considering 2 by 3 r cos theta, 2 by 3 r sine theta, I wanted along the y, but instead of taking the CG of the triangle like we took in case of centroid, here we will take only the radius because both of them are elemental. So y becomes r sine theta, only keep this in mind, y is r sine theta. So what is dIxx along this I want now. dIxx is going to be written as y square into dA. Why y square? This I'm taking as y. CG of the elemental strip is here. So this is y. So dIxx is y square into elemental area, right? That is y square into dA. Now what is the value of y? It is r sine theta. So dIxx will be equal to r sine theta, the whole square, into dA. What is dA? R dr into d theta. Substitute that. R sine theta, the whole square, into r into dr into d theta. Okay, clear? Now see, I have dr and d theta, so I will have two integrations coming into picture, double integration. So dIxx, no? So now if I want Ixx, it is double integration of, once it is 0 to r, once it is angle d theta. So angle for a circle is what? 0 to 360, that is 0 to 2 pi. Correct, no? 2 pi, no? So then inside I will have, I'll open this bracket, this becomes r square sine square theta into r into dr into d theta. This is the equation now. This r square and r, you can make it as one and make it r cube and take it outside also. Okay? So this is your equation, double integration equation, and we have to integrate this. So I will make a note of this and we will start integrating. So we have now Ixx equal to integration 0 to r, integration 0 to 2 pi, r cube sine square theta into dr into d theta. Okay, how do we integrate this now? Integrate this first, afterwards we will take r, right? Or here while writing, you can write it as d theta and dr, so that first we'll finish theta and then we'll go to r. Anyways, outside first integration is r, inner one is theta only. So 0 to r and 0 to pi I will not write here. I will write, what is the integration of sine square theta? I can write it as 1 minus cos 2 theta by 2, right? And here it becomes 0 to 2 pi and dr. Oh, sorry, r cube into dr, we'll keep it like this. 0 to r I have not touched and dr and r cube I have not touched. Sin square theta d theta, I integrated 1 minus cos 2 theta by 2 with the limits 0 to 2 pi. So when I, I have not yet integrated this. This is still integration 0 to 2 pi only. I substituted for sin square as 1 minus cos 2 theta by 2, right? This is d theta. Now 0 to r, integration of this would be what? Theta minus cos becomes sin 2 theta by 2, okay, this half goes out, keep it out. Here I'll put the limits 0 to 2 pi and r cube into dr. This all procedure will be same for even quarter and semicircle, only integration will change, okay. So r square, sine square ko I substituted first as 1 minus cos 2 theta by 2, then I integrated that with respect to theta with the limits. R I have not yet touched. So what is the calculation for this? Half will remain out, 0 to r will remain as it is. So this is going to be 2 pi, right, minus sine of 4 pi divided by 2, r cube and dr are going to remain as they are. So when I again open the brackets 0 to r, re-substituting for this, I will have the value as 2 pi r cube into dr. Okay, so this becomes r cube into dr. Now r cube I have to integrate. So 1 by 2 into 2 pi constant outside, r cube becomes r raised to 4 by 4 with 0 to r as your limits. So what am I left up with now? This 2 is gone over here. R raised to 4, r raised to 4 as it is. So I'll have pi r raised to 4 by 4. Are you also getting the same answer? Pi r raised to 4 by 4 when I substitute for the limits. So Ixx is pi r raised to 4 by 4. What would be Iyy? It is also going to be pi r raised to 4 by 4. Why? Because circle is symmetrical about both the axes. So Ixx and Iyy, they are same, right? So Ixx is also pi r raised to 4 by 4. Iyy also is going to be pi r raised to 4 by 4. There's one more thing over here. You got Ixx equal to Iyy equal to pi r raised to 4 by 4 now. If I want it in terms of diameter, say you want it in terms of diameter. So what is diameter, or what is radius? Is diameter by 2. Substitute r as d by 2. So now your Ixx and Iyy become what? Pi d by 2 raised to 4 by 4. Right? Now d raised to 4 and 2 raised to 4 becomes what? 2 to the 4, 4 to the 8, 4 is 64. So this value becomes pi d raised to 4 by 64. Okay? Your Ixx and Iyy value in terms of diameter are pi d raised to 4 by 64. In terms of radius, it is pi r raised to 4 by 4. So only these two. We are not talking of the about the base. Say still you want to do it about the base. I will give you a base over here. Okay, and I'll call this as AB. What is this distance going to be? The distance between the CG and the base, what is this distance? How much is this distance? Quickly, what is this distance?
D.
This is D. This is D by 2, or it is R. Total is D, diameter of a circle. I have taken, touching the circumference, I have shown a AB. Okay, so this distance is going to be radius. No, from here to here is automatically the radius, or d by 2. Correct? So if I want to find IAB for that particular figure, it is going to be IG plus AD square, where d becomes equal to r, or you can write diameter by 2, your choice. So IAB now is going to be IG, if I want to write in terms of radius, pi r raised to 4 by 4 Ixx, plus area. Area of a circle? And D is going to be R square. So what is this? Pi R raised to 4 by 4 plus pi R raised to 4. R square, R square. This is 1. So here into 4. 4 plus 1, 5. So 5 times of pi R raised to 4 by 4 is your IAB, if AB is touching the circumference of the circle. The same thing, if you want it in diameter, then IG you put it as pi d raised to 4 by 64, and D you can substitute as D by 2. You will get a different one, but that's okay, no need. You can stop your derivation here only. No need to do this IAB also. Derivation can be stopped at this point. Clear? So, if I give you the next question, on find the MI of a, say, semicircle. Semicircle mein this all remains same. DR, D theta, DA will remain same. Your diagram only you will show semicircle, but rest everything will be same. This also remains, this also will be same, because Y will be R sin theta only. Okay. Here when I'm substituting 0 to R, one limit, and 0 to pi becomes your limit in case of a semicircle. And in case of a quarter circle, 0 to pi by 2 becomes the limit. Equation is same, only the limits change, 0 to pi, 0 to pi by 2. Because the limits change, when we substitute here, 0 to pi, 0 to pi by 2, this value will change. This also inside, that is r square, sine square, we will substitute as 1 minus cos 2 theta by 2 only. This substitution also will be same. When I put the limits and cos of pi and cos of pi by 2, then on this values will go on changing. Or else everything will remain same. That is why if you know one derivation of circle perfectly, that means you will be knowing the derivation for semicircle and quarter circle also to do. So procedure of circle, if you know, you will be able to do those two also. That is how they are interlinked. They are easy. Clear? Any doubts with this? Anybody, any doubts? Okay, as you all are not seeing. I've put up a link in the chat box. See whether it's opening and give your attendance there.